Hello all, in this tutorial we are going to solve a linear programming problem using graphical method. So normally we can solve this linear programming problem with two ways. One is graphical method and another one is simplex method. So we will see graphical method, and if the number of constraint is less than 2 or equal to 2, you go for graphical method. If the number of constraint is less than or greater than or equal to 2, you can go for a simplex method. So let me solve a problem. So the problem is max. So the objective function is max z is equal to 6x1 plus 8x2 subject to 5x1 plus 10x2 less than or equal to 60, then 4x1 plus 4x2 less than or equal to 40, where non-negativity conditions are x1, x2 greater than or equal to 0. So first we have to solve using some various steps. First step is we have to calculate the x1 and x2 value for each constraint. So first you have to convert this constraint into a less than or equal to type into a equal to constraint. So that is 5x1 plus 10x2 equal to 60. So we have to get the value for x1 and x2. So for getting that, first you apply x1 is equal to 0. When you apply x1 is equal to 0, x2 is equal to 60 by 10, it is 6. When you apply x2 is equal to 0, we will get x1 is equal to 60 by 5. So 60 by 5 is 12. So we will get 2 points, 0, 6 and 12, 0. So let me take the second constraint, 4x1 plus 4x2 equal to 40. So I have converted less than or equal to type into equal to constraint. So now if you apply x1 is equal to 0, you will get x2 is equal to 40 by 4 is 10. Again, when you apply x2 is equal to 0, you will get x1 is equal to again 40 by 4 is 10. So we'll get two value, 0, 10 and 10, 0. So we have converted or we have calculated the two values x1 and x2 for each constraint. For the first constraint, it is 0, 6 and 12, 0. And for the second constraint, we will have 0, 10 and 10, 0. So now we have to, next step is we have to construct a graph. So this will be the first step. In previous step, we have calculated the value of x1 and x2. Next step is we have to construct a graph. So graph, it will be like this. So we have x1 here, x2 here. So for the first constraint, the value of x1 and x2 is 0, 6, 12, 0. So let me put up the scale. 1, 2, 3, 4, like that I will be putting for x1. So for the first constraint, we'll be having 0, 6 and 12, 0. So for the first constraint, 0, 6. So this will be 0, 6. Then we have 12, 0 here. So now if you construct a line from here to here, it will be the equation like 5x1 plus 10x2 less than or equal to 60. Now we'll plot the second line. So the second line is 0, 10 and 10, 0. So we'll be having 9 here and 10 here. So this is 10 comma 0, and this is 0 comma 10, and you have to construct a line. So this will be the equation 4x1 plus 4x2 less than or equal to 40. Now we have to identify the feasible region. That will be step 3. For step 1, it will be like we have to calculate the value for x1 and x2. Step 2, we have to construct a graph. And step 3, we have to calculate the feasible region. For calculating the feasible region, you have to take some points. For example, normally if it is less than or equal to constrain any region below that, it will be a feasible region. Similarly here, less than or equal to 60, the any region below it is will be a feasible region. So the intersection of the feasible region, you will get the result. So, or another way is you can calculate the point somewhere here, and you can calculate the point somewhere here. If it satisfies this equation, we will be plotting that as the feasible region. For example, let me take the value of x1 as 3 and x2 as 7. So here I am going to take this point 3, 7. If you substitute here, so it will be like 4 into 3, 12, plus 4 into 7, 28. So let me substitute this 3, 7 in this equation. So 4 threes are 12 plus 4 into 7, that is 28, less than or equal to 40. So now it satisfies 40, less than or equal to 40 here. Or if you take another point like 4, 3, so 4 into 4, 16 plus 12. Less than or equal to 40. Now we will be getting 28, which is less than or equal to 40. So this will be the feasible region. That is, the downwards, it will be a feasible region. So the feasible region is like this. Now we have to calculate the feasible region for this line. So 5x1 plus 10x2 less than or equal to 60. So now you take this feasible region. This equation is for this line. So now we have to take any point from here. So it will be like, I am going to take 4, 2. So I'm going to take 4, 2. So 4, 2 is like 20 plus 20. So which is less than or equal to 60. That is 40 less than or equal to 60. So it is satisfied here. So the feasible region is here. So the feasible region for this line is here, from up to this line. And the feasible region for this is up to this line. So the intersection point will be, so the intersection point will be this region. So this will be the feasible region. So now we have to calculate the points of this feasible region. So here it is 0, 0, and this region will be like 10, 0, and this region we have to calculate, and this region it will be like 0, 6. So you can calculate this region by solving these two lines, because it is an intersection of these two lines. So we can solve this by solving these two equations. For example, I'm going to solve these two equations. So let me do it in a separate page, or this page. So first I'm going to multiply the first constraint as this constraint as multiply with say 5. So 20x1 plus 20x2 less than or equal to 200. I'm going to multiply this with 4. So multiply by 4, we'll get 20x1 plus 40x2 less than or equal to 240. Sorry, just convert that into equal to constraint. So minus, so you can cancel this, we'll get minus 20x2 equal to minus 40. So we'll get x2 as 2. When you apply x2 as 2 in this equation, you'll get 20x1 plus 40 listener sorry equal to 200. So 20x1 is equal to 160 and x1 is equal to 8. So this point will be 8, 2. So we got the 4 points as a feasible region. So we get 4 points as feasible region. The first point is 0, 0. Second point is 0, 6. And the third point is 10, 0, 8, 2. So now you have to apply that in Z. So Z is equal to 6x1 plus 8x2. So we'll get Z is equal to 0 here. For this, applying x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 0. On applying x1 is equal to 0, x2 equal to 6, you'll get 8, 6 are 48. And on applying this, you'll get Z is equal to 60. On applying this, you'll get 6 into 8, 48 plus 16. You'll get 64. Since the value of since the problem given as the objective function maximization, so you have to calculate the maximum value of this. The maximum value of this is Z is equal to 64. So the answer we'll get is x1 is equal to 8, x2 equal to 2, and Z is equal to 64. So let me revise. So the given problem is maximization problem with objective function Z is equal to 6x1 plus 8x2, subject to 5x1 plus 10x2 less than or equal to 60, 4x1 plus 4x2 less than or equal to 40. First, we have to convert this less than or equal to type into equal to type. And to calculate the x1 and x2 value, first we assign x1 is equal to 0, you will get x2. Again, x2 is equal to 0, you will get x1. So by using this, you will be getting this point. Now using this point, you have to draw the graph. So this will be the graph. So for the first constraint, we will be getting this graph from this line, and the second constraint will be getting this graph. So you have to calculate whether the area is below or upper point. So to calculate whether the area is below or upper area, you have to check, you have to take any point here or here. So if you take any point here, it satisfies the condition, so the region will be down. And here also, if you take any point here, it will be down. So if you take here any point above this region, it won't be satisfied. So you can easily calculate this. So the intersection point will be like this area, which is marked in a green color line, and we have to calculate the points. So 0, 0 will be the first point, 0, 6 will be the second point, 10, 0, 8, 2. So you have to take that point and you have to substitute in Z. So for applying the first point, you'll get 0, for the second it's 48, and third is 60, and the fourth one is 64. Since the objective function is maximization, you have to calculate the maximum of these values. So the maximum this value is 64, so you'll be getting x1 is equal to 8 and x2 equal to 2. So the solution is to increase the maximum profit of this objective function, you can assign x1 is equal to 8 and x2 equal to 2. Thank you.